And Granny said, I believe that was our ring.
Well, it might not have been, but it sure sounded like it to me. Won't you answer it,
Lauck? Hello, jot him down, store.
Yeah.
This is Lyman Abner.
And now, let's see what's going on down in Pine Ridge.
Well, morning, Grandpap, old buddy. Where are you heading first early in the morning?
Oh, Friday, Abner. Oh, just out for a little morning constitution.
Well?
I might walk down to the store with you. No place to go much.
You ain't just anxious to find out what's in that trunk Lum went and bought sight unsaw, are you?
Trunk? What trunk's that?
You know what trunk. One he paid $100 for over to the freight auction at Hot Springs yesterday.
Oh, that one.
Now,
that
Grandpap, don't go making off like you ain't curious. You'd like to gnaw the Lauck off yesterday when you found out Lum didn't get a key to the thing.
Why, I never know such a thing, Abner. You was the one that was mighty nigh flipping your wig. Like to bent your eyeballs out of shape trying to see through the keyhole.
Prattle, prattle.
And a double prattle, prattle to you.
All right, let's both stop right here. Now, neither one of us will go in the store.
That's just fine and dandy with me. Curiosity's never got the best of me yet.
Me neither. The only reason I got up early was... Well, of course, I couldn't sleep.
And my clock was wrong this morning, hour fast. Well, now, no use in both of us standing here lying to one another.
No, let's get over there before Lum opens the thing up.
Yeah. Did Lum get a key for the pigeon-toed trunk yet?
Well, the locksmith come over from the county seat last night and taken an impression of the Lauck. Lum went back with him. I don't think he got back till late.
Well, don't run so fast. I can't keep
but
up.
I want to get in there, Grandpap.
I didn't see no light in the store up till 10 o'clock last night.
Did you set up till 10 o'clock watching?
Well, not special for that.
Grandpap, I believe you did.
I never neither, Abner. Only reason I set up till 10 is because it was Tuesday.
Tuesday? Now, why would you set up till 10 o'clock on a Tuesday?
Because I thought it was Wednesday.
Grandpap, I believe you're curiouser than I am. I just set up till about 9 o'clock.
Well, Abner, when a fella gets my age, about the only fun left is to sit around and wait for somebody to open something up. I don't want to miss nothing, I'll admit that. But I ain't curious.
Now, hold on, Lum. I don't believe Lum's in too much of a hurry to open that trunk anyway. I think he's kind of ashamed.
Shamed?
Sure. Once he opens the trunk, why, everybody will find out how silly he was for paying $100 for it.
Well, let's hurry and get in there. He might have opened it up and found out there wasn't nothing much in there. And then closed it again. We never would get to see what was in there then.
Oh, for the land's sakes, I've just got to know what's in there. Come on, let's hurry and get in there. Hurry up. Come on, Grandpa. Get in the door here. Let's get in there. Okay. Hey, Lum, did you open it up yet?
Huh? Oh, the trunk?
Yeah.
No, I ain't. And quit worrying.
Good, good. Hooray.
Yeah, let's get the pigeon-toed thing open there, Lum. When I get curious, I get excited. And when I get excited, I get the hiccups.
Hurry up, Lum.
Will you please calm down, fellas? I'll open it just as soon as Ulysses gets back.
Ulysses? Lum, if you're just stalling because you think I'd get mad if there's nothing in there, well, just don't
What
do
the
it.
World has Ulysses got to do with the whole
salmon-legged
business
anyway?
Lum, for the land's
sake, you went and bought the trunk.
I don't know what you mean. If you made a mistake,
as long as you bought it, you might as well find out what's in it.
You're the kind of a fellow that'd try to whistle out of something.
I just quit stalling and open the thing up.
Better get me a dip of water. I'm getting a hiccup.
Oh, now look what you went and done, Lum.
I went and done.
Yeah, hold your breath, Grandpap. I'll get you some water.
For pity's sake, what's the matter with you fellers anyway? Ain't you ever seen the inside of a trunk before? I told you I'd open it just as soon as you listened.
Got the key, ain't you, Lum? Now open it up. Here, Grandpap. Drink it slow now.
I don't see why I've got to go and explain every dad blame move I made. But I guess I better. Ulysses went with me to the county seat yesterday and drove me back. I left the key to the trunk in his car.
All right.
He brung it to me, but I went and lost it again. And right now, this minute, Ulysses...
If you're ashamed to open the trunk, Lum, just come out and say so.
I ain't ashamed of anything I ever done, Abner Peabody. And if you don't quit incinerating I am, I'm going to whop you right over the head. Give me that dipper, Grandpa.
Well, gentlemen, gentlemen.
Oh, for pity's sake.
I thought I heard voices raised in here. What seems to be the trouble, gentlemen?
Lum won't open that knock-kneed trunk, Squire. Don't want us to have no fun.
Oh, so that's the mysterious trunk right there, huh?
Hold on here, Squire. What do you mean by mysterious trunk?
Well, it's all over town, Lum. Seems that you made a mysterious visit to Hot Springs and picked up this trunk at the depot there.
Well, what's so mysterious about buying a trunk at an auction?
Well, the fact that you paid $1,000 for the thing.
$1,000? I never paid no $1,000.
Mom, you told me you only paid $100.
Well, the price more than likely gets upped a few dollars every time it hops from tongue to tongue, you know. Of course, I tried to poo-poo the idea that there was contraband goods in there.
Contraband?
Well, they're smuggled, stolen, illegal in one way or another, Mom.
I'll be dead blamed. I'll be dead blamed.
Well, it looks like a good, sturdy trunk there, Lauck.
If that don't take the rag off in the brush. Here I am, a peaceful citizen of Pine Ridge, minding my own business. I buy an innocent trunk at a public auction, and all of a sudden I'm mixed up with a gang of thieves or something.
Well, all of the folks ain't claiming that now.
Well, now, that's mighty thoughty of them.
One element is holding out for the idea that you are the victim of a ring of counterfeiters.
Why don't you open the bow-legged thing and find out?
Yeah, for the land's sake, Lom, open it.
I will just as soon as I get the key. Ulysses is just... Or wait a minute. Wait a minuet. Maybe I won't open.
Well, now, Lom, I believe it'd pay to get some legal advice on the thing first.
Legal advice on opening a trunk?
Well, yes, Lom, I think that's a good idea.
What I need is a key.
No, no, now, it just happens that I have had considerable experience in handling shady deals.
Well, I ain't surprised at that.
Well, strictly as advisor to the innocent party, you understand.
Oh, sure, sure.
And a sturdy trunk like this doesn't get left in a freight depot for no reason, Lom. Now, you may be the tool of a vicious gang of uranium thieves. At this very moment, wicked eyes might be watching your every move.
I'm getting scared.
Hey, fellas, excuse me. What's in it, Mr. Lum?
Counterfeit?
Just hold on now, Cedric.
Boy, I'd sure like to see $1,000,000 worth of counterfeits. Is a counterfeit a fancy thing that fits on the counter?
Never mind, Cedric. Just be quiet a minute, please. Lum? Now, you've got to move cautiously. You may have top atomic secrets in that trunk, for all you know. Foreign agents may have cleverly switched this trunk over to you to avoid suspicion.
Huh.
Just waiting for the whole thing to blow over so they can pounce on you. And in the meantime, the government's liable to do some pouncing itself. And believe me, they've got some awful powerful pouncers in the FBI.
Just what are you getting at, Squire?
Only trying to help you out, love. I am actually putting myself on the spot by offering my services as legal advisor. Of course, I would expect a little something in return. Oh, say, half innocent in the trunk, in case it's a big reward, or I guess overshot myself a little there.
I thought so. I ain't giving no half interest to nobody, and I'm going to open it when I feel like opening it.
Well, you're getting the dad blame thing out of this store, then.
Well, that's just fine. I'll take it over to my office.
Here, what's that, Lum?
I'm taking this trunk over to the office I leased from you.
Sir, now, hold on, Lum. I don't want any government men snooping around my office. There's a few things I wouldn't...
All right, then. Give me back my rent money and break the lease.
Oh, no, I can't do that, Lum. You see, well, the facts. See, here... Hey, what's that?
Jumping toad frogs. There's something inside that trunk.
Hey, Lum. Hey, Lum. It's dark in here. Can you hand me a match?
Great balls of fire. There's a voice coming out of that trunk. Don't bring that thing over to my place, Lum. At least it's open.
Yeah, I'm getting out of here.
Get out of my way, Grandpa.
We'll see you later, Mr. Lum.
What's the matter with folks anyway, letting their imaginations run away with them like that? Just a minute, and I'll get you a match.